Hey guys, welcome back. Let's farm Stardew Valley, episode 40. All right, so we are on last week of winter. So let's go ahead and get started. Last week we got into the casino last week, and we got some other things. We got we just got one more week left to go of this summer. Oh yeah, and I've been doing a little bit of research. Well, I've been doing a little bit of reading on some of the things here and there on the game. I've been looking up I've just been looking around the wiki, just looking at things, just kind of learning a little bit more about the game, some of the things I didn't know about. And just kind of find out what needs to be done, things I guess I haven't learned yet about the game itself. Well, I guess I should tell you what I've been looking around. I've been looking about the caverns, some of the last item on our shipping list, our shipping right here. This particular item. I know what this is. This is the sweet gem fruit. That, remember when we grew one, we gave it to that statue down in the Secret Woods. Yeah, we actually never shipped one, so. Okay. So. Whenever we get one, whenever we grow one, we'll definitely get another one. Alright, so I can assume that none of the goats have milked in there. I don't know how that happened. That wasn't even close. Okay, so what exactly? Yeah, that's right. It's been raining a lot the past few days. Oh, I did get a goat milk. Okay. Did I get it? Oh, I got 3 duck eggs today. Wow, that's a lot. Oh, yeah, I saw Captain America. I saw Captain America yesterday. Captain America Civil War. And it was actually really good. From what my friend told me after we finished watching the movie, he said that the director has never even gone to that type of genre. That kind of drama whatever they did with they never done like that type of genre or that type of films with the Captain America movie. They never venture into that, and it was their first time like doing something of that genre. And I think he said that they were best known for. Jeez, Arrested Development. Enough. Jeez. Yeah, he said they were best known for Arrested Development, which is like, I was like, what? And that was like their very first time they did anything of that kind of. Anything of that kind of range, so it's that was really interesting. I was like, wow, that's pretty. I was like, that's pretty fucking impressive. You know, like, that's pretty impressive to go from like a comedy into like something like to something like to a Marvel movie. No, that's quite amazing. I'm not gonna spoil it, not gonna say what happens in the movie, but I will say that if you like the Marvel movies, you like the superhero movies, like all the superhero movies, any of the superhero movies, I definitely would like to. I definitely say that Captain America is the movie itself is very worth your time to watch. There's a lot of good funny moments, a lot of just great cinematic moments itself. Makes you wonder, like, is and I'm wondering whose side am I on, who was right and who was wrong in the film? Because that's one of the big things about the film, like who was right, who was wrong. Like, who you think was right in the way they approach things? Who you think was completely wrong on how they should have dealt with it? This is not spoiling anything to the whole film itself, but it's pretty much what happens is what the major conflict of the whole film is it's a civil war between the heroes themselves, the heroes, and basically the civil war is about, or what they're fighting about is whether or not to sign this a particular law or some kind of ratification for them being superheroes. And what I mean by that is like something to where they couldn't. Because before, like, as the heroes came along, as when the Avengers were created, they were pretty much able to kind of go wherever they wanted, without any kind of like anybody giving them the green light to go. If they felt like there was something wrong or like something they had to go do, anywhere they could just go, like just like real superheroes, like I need to go help out these people over here. Or like, oh, I heard there was something going on over here. It's like. They'd be like, oh yeah. And they go and. What the hell? And they just go and do what they want, and you know, and they just do a lot of damage. And pretty much, that thing was pretty much what they wanted was like the heroes to have come some kind of leash. Somebody, people to pretty much. I think they say, like, can we go do this? And they were like, no. Or. And I go, so pretty much just something to kind of like, somebody's authority to kind of pretty much tell them that whether or not they could do something if they, instead of letting them do as they please. No, I won't have any left. Oh, that's the point, then let's just grow more of these then. Oops. Pretty much, that's what the whole premise of the thing was. Like, pretty much, Iron Man and some of the other ones, like, he's like, yeah, we need to have somebody to make sure that we can't just act on our own, because, you know, we cause a lot of destruction, we cause a lot of damage that we need to be taken responsibility, or pretty much, like, we need to be responsible for what we do. And Captain America is like, it's like, we shouldn't have anybody to hold us back to saying that if we need to go do something, if we need to go and stop something or stop a villain from doing something, we shouldn't have anybody to say that we can't have somebody say, no, you can't go do that. You have to wait for us to say, give us the green light. And you know, and us, there are just the other heroes, heroes are like up for it, and some of the other heroes aren't for it. And pretty much they just fight each other. That's all it was. And that's pretty much all I will say about the film. I will say that Spider-Man did get a lot more screen time than I thought. Like, he really did get a lot more screen time than I had thought he would. Pretty much the screen time they gave him was more than enough for him to pretty much have a very, very short origins. Pretty much saying like, oh, how did you get your powers? Like, oh, I got it because of this. Well, he didn't ever say he got bit by a spider. It pretty much says, pretty much everyone knows that Spider-Man got his abilities from a spider. You know, he got bit by a spider, and that's how he got it. And pretty much it was just like Tony being like, hey man, kind of need you here to help us out with this situation here, and I'll help you out making you a very nice high-tech suit for you to wear. Then he was like, okay, I'm for that. And he's like, and that's pretty much how that situation got resolved and started and resolved. I don't know, but that's pretty much about it, though. I don't know too much. I don't read too much into the Marvel Universe. I do know some of the heroes in the Marvel Universe, but I'm not, like... But the problem is, to me, I just don't... It's not that I don't like the Marvel Universe at all. I do. I just... To me, I really just like... I really like the DC Universe just a little bit more. I really like the heroes... I really love the superheroes in the DC Universe. I don't know, to me, they just... to me, the DC Universe heroes are always... They always felt more real to me than anybody, than any of the other superheroes. Oopsies. It's just because of... I really don't know why, they really just felt more... The DC superheroes just feel more... human. It would just feel more human to me. Just the way how they do the things, or just the way they interact with things, is just the way they are. I mean, like their problems and stuff like that, just seems a little bit more. I guess the seriousness of it. It's more. A lot of DC is a lot more noir than anything else. There's a lot of noir elements in it, and I really like that, especially like Batman stuff. You know, and I'm really beginning to really like the Flash. The Flash is quickly become one of my favorite superheroes. See, to me, I don't have a particular favorite Marvel hero, though. That's the thing. Like, there are Marvel heroes I do like, but there's none of them that I really like Spider-Man. Or I really like Iron Man, or I really like, or I really like Wolverine, or stuff like that, or any other hero. Like, I really just don't have a particular favorite Marvel hero, and that's pretty much kind of just like I could tell because I don't have many Marvel hero shirts at all. I think the only Marvel hero shirt of a superhero I have is probably Iron Man. And if anything, I probably do like Iron Man the most. Not because of Robert Downey Jr. or anything. Not saying he's not a good Iron Man, he is. The only reason I've always liked Iron Man before. And I think Iron Man was the first comic I actually... The first comic I actually asked for my birthday when I was a kid. You know, I asked my mom, like, can you get me Iron Man comics for my birthday? She's like, okay. And she probably didn't know how to find them. You know, my mom. She probably asked my uncle to go find them for her. And I got like two Iron Man comics. And I was happy. I was like, oh sweet, yeah, Iron Man comics. Like, oopsies. So I've always been a fan of Iron Man. So I guess that kind of says that, like, I am an Iron Man fan. Which one of these counts are not milk? You? I milked you, I know that. Maybe you. Always skip one. I think you guys can hear the sound of my voice. Just the way my tone is today. I don't know why. I just feel really, really odd today. Like, I don't know what it is. Like, I really don't. I just feel unmotivated today. Oh, I just feel like, I don't know. Jesus Christ, get off of me! It wouldn't be that bad, but good God, man, when they got that slow effect on you two, and you're just running there, just beating your ass down. I think those slimes are more trouble than they're worth, to be honest. Alright, so the wheat and stuff, I'm pretty much able to keep that stuff growing without any hassle. So those can keep, I can just keep buying those. I don't have to worry about in season stuff for those at all. Need that. Really, really waiting for the. I really want to know the expected launch date for the 1.1 patch. Blueberries are always welcome. Always welcome to make more. Always welcome to have more blueberries. I think I could probably get at least two more harvests out of these blueberries. Oh, actually, I found out something just a little. Oh yeah, I also found out something just a while ago, and I'll go show you guys right now before I forget. Oh yeah, just ship everything. Iridium ore. Don't really need that. I should have shipped the battery packs. I forgot to put those up, did I? Yeah, wheat and stuff, I don't have to worry about wheat and stuff. It was here, my bad. Oh, what I learned was, pretty much, the more time the tree has been on your farm, the more it's aged, the better quality of fruit you get. So that's nice. So, pretty much by the end of 2 years, if a tree's been on your plot, a tree has been on your farm plot for like at least 2 years, you will get a gold star of that fruit, which is nice. That's nice. Cause like you've seen where I'm going to the fruit cave, the cave in there, and I gotten like some gold star fruit, like the gold star cherries and the gold star oranges. And I always wonder, I was like, can I get more of these? It always weirded me out. So why don't my trees give me like a silver star or anything? It just give me like regular star fruits and stuff. So yeah, so I just learned that with the patch. I read up on the patch of 1.07. See what changes were there. Just some very nice minor small changes here and there. Like nothing too major, nothing too big. Just more like dialogue. I think also your spouse will stand next to you during some festivals, particular festivals and stuff. All right, so we need to go buy some wheat seeds. So we need 48. Alright, so I need to get this episode done. And then once this episode's done, I need to go ahead and start uploading these up to YouTube. and get those going, and then start working on the next episodes this coming up week. Carp surprise. Actually, that was not what I was meant to show you. This was what I meant to show you right here. This arcade. Remember this arcade right here? This machine, one of these machines here, we weren't able to access. Not this game. It was this game here. Remember earlier, very early in this, when I started playing this game, we couldn't access this particular arcade machine because there was something missing. Well, once you have the skull key here, you can play this game. And, oh, cool. So it's kind of like the Donkey Kong minecart thing. Ow. Alright, so let's play this for just a little bit, not too long. Ooh. Okay. Okay. Jeez, man. Wow, I'm really bad at this game. Super bad at this game. Super bad. Okay. Okay, let's just do this again. Okay, it's kind of odd because I don't know, this like it feels like there's a delay. See, does these control do anything, or do I just press the jump button? Oh boy, that looks very difficult. Come on, there we go. We can go. And it only took all of our fucking lives to get all the way out there. I think that if you get farther enough through the progress mode, you can get something from the game. Well, you get another game, something from the game. You get like a different mode. What's the point of that? Okay. Some of these jumps are just really, really weird. Like, okay, that's it. I'm not gonna play that anymore. I'm just gonna get mad if I keep playing that. Is there anything back here other than just barrels of wine and beer? Guess not. All right, so that's pretty much what I saw. I looked that up. I was looking around. I saw that the arcade, and I saw that hey, that unlocks that. Wow, what? Sure. Aiden. Level 23 rancher. I'll eat this from the trash. Alright, so let's go plant these wheat seeds and go ahead and finish the day off. Now today's gonna be a longer episode because we gotta play all the way. We gotta finish the summer. So we're playing to the 28th. Past the 28th, and this will be our last week of summer, our last week of a year 3 in our summer. And after that, I think after that I will have only 6 episodes left to do, which means the last 4 weeks, the last month of fall, which will be all one episode each. Each week will be one episode, and then for the winter. I'm going to try to cut the winter down to 2 episodes, so I'm going to be doing a lot of... I'm trying to finish the winter episodes up really quick. Because, like as you guys all know, there's nothing to do in the winter season, so pretty much a lot of the winter episodes would be just pretty much... go to sleep, wake up, tend to the animals, then go right back to sleep. Tend to the animals, maybe wait around to 12 o'clock, maybe wait around till these things are finished, and just go straight off to, just go straight to bed, and don't even worry about anything else. Well, I might just have it where I can just put everything in the thing, ship whatever I have left over, and just go straight to the next day. Because when I go straight to the next day, I can just go straight to the next day, and I can just pretty much be like boom, 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 boom. Just kind of knock the days out really, really quick. But you know, it's not. And there's nothing to do in winter, so it's very damn boring. It's very boring. I don't want to bore you guys with, you know, like the lack of stuff to do in the winter. There's only two festivals during the winter, which one is like the ice fishing festival and the Winter Vale festival, which is at the end of the month. Oh, she's a toddler now. Oh, look at her. I wonder if there'd be any kind of key differences between her and my other baby boy. We're doing Grace and Leon. Maybe Grace might have like a pink. Maybe Grace might have like a pink onesies. Oh, okay, that's just Honey. Talk to everybody. Tell them I love them. Love them so I can tell. So I can look at all this fucking hay that did not. The stupid automatic feeder that does not work. I kind of miss the brushing mechanic of the game. Well, not brushing mechanic. I mean, like, in Harvest Moon, you can brush the animals. Like the cows, your horse, the sheep, and probably your goats, not your pig, because they don't particularly have fur on them. If you do have the automatic feeder for your barns and your coops, make sure you check them every day to make sure that it is actually dispensing food, because sometimes they won't, as you've seen. And it's just... And then you'd be like, hey, why not get any food? Or like, why didn't I get any animal products today? And then you see that you talk to them and they're all pissed off at you. You're like, my bad? Alright, so I didn't see any crops that were finished today. Let's see, and we have one last event during our last festival event. Oh, don't put that in there. Let's see, what else do I have in here? I only have one of coconuts. I kinda wish I could grow coconuts, but coconuts. You can't grow coconuts like this type of environment. How the hell did now that makes me wonder now, like, how is coconut growing in the desert? There's no way a coconut can grow in the desert, is there? I know coconut trees grow very particularly well in the sand or on the sandy beaches or just on beaches and stuff. I don't know. Alright, put those away. Let's see. Talk to Rocco here. And I did check, I do have all the scarecrows. I do. I don't know why I've only count 7, but I do have all 8 of the rare crows. Because I was looking around, that's what I was looking at yesterday. I was like, wait a minute, there's no way. I was like, I have to have all the scarecrows because there's nowhere else I can buy them. And I pretty much looked up the rare crows where you can attain each one. I was like, I've already attained each one because I bought each one and I found each and I got each one. And there's nothing, you don't get any achievement for owning each one or having each one. It's pretty much just something. And there's no significance to having all the rare crows. It's just something if you want to do on your own, or if you just want to have, then you can have. You can just do that. Alright, so let's go ahead and turn this rest of this stuff in. Alright. And let's put in these corn, this corn back in here. And this ancient fruit. I'm seriously considering making more of these wines. Like, I'm considering making like 8 more of these. Or at least a few more over here. Oh, I need to put these up. I don't know why I'm walking around with them. Okay, so are these my animal products ready yet? Yes. I don't know about the wool. The wool takes just a little bit more time. Like, just a bit. Just a little bit more time. So I'm just gonna try to wait for those. And I'll start getting some of this grass. So apparently every 3 cuts of grass, every cut of 3 pieces of grass equals 1 hay. Which to me kind of sucks because I was like, why can't just one patch of grass equal one hay? Not cutting all of them, I'm just gonna get enough of them to where I can get just a few more pieces. Yeah, there we go. Just a few more pieces, so I have a little bit more left to do. A little bit left to kind of keep going on the season. Right, those pickle radishes went through pretty quick. Right, what else? All right, so let's just get some beets then. Right, put those away, and then Baby Grace. And Leon's all the way at 7 hearts. What's up, buddy? Let's watch the TV. Oh. Alright, so we're done for today. We're done. Let's keep going on the road, guys.
Roll.
Yeah, so I gotta upload all these by today, and upload them, schedule them, and write all the info and infos and tags. Oh my god, uploading takes a long time. Well, uploading honestly don't take that long. It's the processing takes long more than anything else. I don't mind writing the info stuff down for the game, like the info and stuff like that. I don't mind writing down stuff and just trying to figure out like little nice catchy little stuff. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. So yeah, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I don't know how the hell I miscount that. I must not have been counting one of them. Oh. It's feeder, Jesus, man, will you work? It makes me mad when it doesn't make me mad that I have to do more work. It just makes me mad that it doesn't work all the time. It's like, why? You know, there's no faultiness. If there's faultiness to it, then why can't I just call Robin to say, hey Robin, the automatic feeder is not working for some reason today. It's like, oh, okay, I'll come by and check it out. See, that doesn't mean like little nice little features to add to the game, you know, like if something doesn't work, you know, call somebody. You can call a villager, like, hey, this is not working for some reason. It's like, oh, okay, I'll come by and check it out. I'll come by and look at it and see what's wrong. You know, kind of like your fences, because your fences will break over time. Like, it'd be kind of nice to have, like, if your equipment stuff, like, especially, like, these type of equipment kind of breaks over time, like, kind of degrades or not stop working over time. Just to add just a bit of realism to the game. Also, it kind of adds, like, I guess more things to kind of use your money for. And kind of help increase the town's economy system as well. Because, I mean, essentially, you have the... You and the mayor have, like, the most amount of fucking money. And, like, towards the end game like this, there's nothing to do. There's nothing to use your money on. So, to me, I think it'd be nice just to kind of have, like, these little things here and there. To kind of, like, hey, use your money here. Because, fix some things here or fix some things here. Like, that'd be just nice to have into the game. Not particularly anything that makes me mad. But, you know, just things like that would just... As small things like that kind of enhances the game more than people think. You know, some people think that just sounds like a hassle more than anything else. Like, it does. Jesus Christ, get the hell off of me. Look at it. It's constantly applying the debuff. God, I lost that much health? I honestly don't think it's worth even having these slimes in there. I honestly do. I mean, they've done nothing for me other than causing misery. What is all this? Cherry, 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 orange. Oh, okay, I know what they mean. Boom, boom, boom. Get those out of there. I would like to try the cactus fruit, but I guess I would like to try it without just the fruit itself. Like, nothing else on it. You don't want to eat a cactus fruit and fucking have a thorn or a prick in there. Prick the hell out of your mouth. Oh, that would suck. Oh, that totem. It's like, So make the money. Make all the money. I might be able to get that statue. I might be able to get that statue by fall. Yeah, by fall, probably. Depends how much I make during the end of this episode. I'm pretty sure by the end of the episode, I'll probably have at least 800,000. Not sure how much of 800,000. Let's see. Let me guesstimate. I'm guessing probably about not 850,000. I don't think I'll be at that much. Actually, I might be able to get that much. I might. But I'm thinking more around maybe 830,000. That is what I'm guessing. $830,000. Well, the reason why I say that is because I'm gonna have one last big shipment of the blueberries. I'm gonna have the melons themselves, and I'm gonna have some radishes here and there, and stuff like that. So I'm gonna have a few more stuff here to ship within the next few days. Let's see, let's look at the calendar. Yep. And to sleep we go. And it's rain today. And let's see, 777,000. You're not gonna say anything, are you? I was like, maybe she's mad at me? I was like, no, she's not mad. Where's my baby boy? Apparently he's not in here. Is he behind the bear statue again? Nope. Well, he was just below me a while ago. I guess he disappeared. As long as he don't walk into the void, I'm okay. Can't. Thank you, buddy. I really don't have any need to collect these really more anymore because of the statue. So I really don't have a need to kind of. Jesus, it's not working today again. Either A, it's not working, or B, they're already eating the food. But you can't take a chance of them already eating the food, because if you do take a chance, like, maybe they already ate today. It's like, mm-mm. And you come back the next day, you come back tomorrow, and they're all pissy at you. You're like, oh, shit. Okay. I'm hoping that the next patch will also add some age to your children, like... I'm not looking them to. I like the fact that they do hit the toddler age, but that's where it stops though. You know, they just stay toddlers for the rest of the time. I kind of hope they can reach the age, not to where the age of like Jazz and Vincent, because Jazz and Vincent are probably about 7-8 years old each. But at least like, I don't know, maybe like a 2-year-old, like a 3-year-old, where they can talk a little bit and they can receive gifts. And then they can grow up to and they can have like random likes, dislikes, and stuff like that. Just add like a little bit of personality to your children. It'd be really nice. I know, it'd be kind of like the Harvest Moon, It's a Wonderful Life, where like, not depending on who you friend, but depending on what you give them and whatever they're kind of exposed to the most, it'll depend like what kind of stuff they grow up liking. I think that'd be really fucking awesome, you know, just be like, hey, my kid, like, I'm a farmer, so my kid, like, his favorite fruit is the blueberries, or his favorite fruit is the cranberries, or his favorite vegetable is this particular thing. See, I don't know, I just think that just having some minor stuff like that would be really, really, really nice. Alright, so got some pine tar. Joe. Okay, before I decide to destroy these slimes, I'm gonna wait until I can... As you saw, that was just a fit of rage of slash. Oh, I got 100. Exactly 100. Wonder if I'm like, it was worth killing them. I don't, to be honest, if they say like, they honestly make me mad every time I go walk in there. Thunder, hops. I think hops is the only thing we got today. Okay. and a peach. Peach and some jams. I've been wondering if I need to make, if I should make more preserved jars. But I don't, but I really don't want to because, I don't know. Preserves themselves, preserve jars are getting jelly and pickle stuff is nice. And they are artisan goods as well. But to me, I don't know, I just don't like them. I just don't like the preserved things. I really don't know why. Like, the wine stuff, I really like. Like, I guess because you get more money, I think because you probably get more from preserves. I think you get more from what making them into wine than you do preserves. Alright, so that's done. So all we have to do is wait on our animal goods. Oh, I need two for those. Idea what I'm doing. Okay. Alright, so that's done. So let's go ahead and end the day then. Closer and closer. Wow, this episode's going real. I'm making this episode really fast. Commentary has not been great either. I might be because I feel a little sick. I don't feel sick. My stomach feels a little weird. I think that's what's really kind of messing with me a little bit. It's just kind of your stomach. My stomach's kind of like, eh. So I'm kind of like, eh. And it's raining again today. Now you can always tell it's raining whenever you hear Krovis making a sound. What the hell are you doing, Rocco? Oh. I should have known that, to be honest. Look at her, she's so cute. I would like to change the floor in there, ground floor into. Okay, so it looks like we have melons today. Melons and blueberries, which are fantastic to have on both days. We also have honey. Let's see. The feeder is actually working today. So today might be nope, it's a void egg. That just sounds nasty. Alright, so all those are done. All you guys are taken care of. Oh damn it, did I ship my ice cream? Yeah, I think I did. Ah, well that's fine, whatever. I don't particularly need it. I just carry it around just in case if I decide to randomly go into the skull mines. Talk to me. Okay. That always made weird me out. Okay. if I haven't said this before, when I used to play World of Warcraft, I just like something just talk. Well, I said talk to me. That just reminded me of the troll women. Cause sometimes they'll just say that, like, talk to me. I was like, what do you want me to talk about? I always thought it was weird that was one of their dialogue thing where you click on them and you ask them for something, they were like, talk to me. Alright, so we need to, okay, I need to start saving, no, not this. Oh crap, I need to start saving those. Okay, I got a blue slime egg. Alright, I'm just gonna keep these in there now. Now, I'm going to have at least a blue and a red. A blue and another slime egg. Okay, so what else? Wait. What's today's date? Friday. Oh, I think I know what happens to the JoJo Mart after you complete all your bundles. Like, I don't know if I want to tell you guys just yet, or if I want to wait until that event particularly happens. But I do know what I guess I will keep it a secret until that event happens. Cause I do know what happens. Alright, so we're just gonna keep these away and put the overs in there. Alright, so we need to go buy some more wheat seeds. There's supposed to be some kind of effect if lightning hits a fruit tree. I don't know exactly what that effect is. Apparently it's supposed to have some kind of special effect on the fruits. Alright, so this is actually a really big harvest day, to be honest. Those aren't ready. Of course they're not ready because the other ones aren't ready. Alright, I'll keep 5 of those melons to myself. Just to keep 5 melons. Okay, and then let's check the cave. Let's check in here. Check the cave. Nothing. Let's check the greenhouse. Let's see if anything's finished around the greenhouse. Nothing. Okay. Alright, so I'm actually gonna ride Sedgerald today. Because I haven't ridden him in a while, because I've been just finishing the days off very quickly. I know, I'll get those in a bit. Alright, so melons. Okay, I only have 3. That's right, I remember now. I only had 3 because I forgot I didn't put any fertilizer on them last time around. Alright, so let's go see what Merchant Lady has for sale today. She appears every Sunday and Friday. Or Friday and Sunday. Alright, so pumpkin soup, trout soup, bok choy seed, those are fall. Pufferfish, slime. I'll take one just so I can have it. The little tree. That's a nice little flourish piece. Okay, that's about it. Alright. Thunder, thunder, thunder. Sounds like it has hit something pretty hard down there. Let's see. And we need to go here, and we need to buy some more wheat seeds. I'm not gonna buy any wheat seeds for that plot where the melons used to sit at, because by the time Well, pretty much by the time it hits fall for us. Yeah, pretty much by the time it hits fall for us, it's already gonna be too late. It's gonna be like that plot's gonna be sitting there, and I won't be able to grow anything on it for another 2 days because the wheat's still growing. So I'm just gonna let it ride out. I'll just let it ride out until then. And our last day should be fairly simple, because all we have to do is pretty much do our chores. Do our daily chores, and then I'm actually not even putting animal products to the artisan to the makers, just so we can don't have to worry about them. Well, I don't know. That just depends. If I was like, oh wait, I shouldn't walk through that when it's raining. That'll be that. Alright, so that plot of land is finished. Now, alright, we'll put Sedgero up and put this one slime up. Actually, no, I'll just keep it on me. I don't care. I'll just put it in tomorrow. Alright, and we have this little portrait of a tree. Which I'm gonna put, like here. What do you mean by that? We've been married for almost 2 years now. Almost a year now. We've been married for a year now. I forgot, because we got married on the first day of summer. Yeah, that's what we got married on the first day of summer. I was kind of hoping there'd be like a little thing like Harvest Moon does, like if like your wife would does something for you, like hey, like you come in like at night or something, and she'd be like, hey, you know what today is, and you kind of have a guess, like it's my birthday, is it our anniversary or our son's birthday. Like, I mean, that stuff is nice, you know, just having those little things. It makes it feel more like a family when you have a big family like that. Wow, 3 days straight? You know what I need to do? I need to add this. Since I got time, I'm gonna add these chairs here. I guess I could rearrange some of the stuff in the house. Actually, no, I'll do that when I come back. Because I just realized, like, it's not gonna be me and my wife sitting at the table anymore. It's gonna be me and my two kids and my wife. So I'm gonna have to put four tables in that little, that table up there in our kitchen. And luckily for me, I have been collecting those. I have been collecting stuff like that. Give me that wool, baby. Okay. Don't tell me you're not giving milk because you couldn't go outside. Ooh, man. Well, she just looks fine. See, these animals are so finicky every now and then. It's so weird about them. That's just the only thing that worries me out about them. It's how finicky they are sometimes. 3 and 1. Alright, then to this. Please do not make me turn my please do not make me turn around and use my sword. Come on, get over here. I don't need you to block the doorway. I was considering like just to turn around and slashing him. I was sat there. I was like, no, just wait. If you guys out there and look at it, he's like, I can see the anger in your eyes, boy. Oh, what the hell? Oh my god, I hate thunderstorms so much. Could they destroy small plots of your area? And if you don't realize it, or you don't see it enough times, this is... Oh my god. You know, I just saw it. It's right here. It's very annoying. I don't know about coconut wine. I've had coconut rum, and coconut rum is delicious. Delicious to really mix stuff with. Taking shots of coconut rum is not. Taking shots of anything that's sweet to me. Sweet is to me. It's just. That is just rough, man. I don't know why. It's just super rough, man. It's just like you take a shot of that. You're just like, oh god, that doesn't go down well at all. All right, these are also ready. Here, so grab that. Okay, yep. Nice. Alright, this is a fairly big harvest today. That's a lot of stuff here. Corn, the red pepper, the red peppers. Some of the radishes, the starfruit, especially the starfruit. But it's nice to have like a back-to-back. Let's see if the potatoes and the Wow, 31. Yeah. I did it because I could do this. Put some more preserves in there. Oh wow, we might actually hit the 850 mark. More than 850, just because of those star fruit. I think that's going to be the big selling factor. Okay, so from here, I'm going to go ahead and get rid of some of these plants. Like the hot peppers. These will not be growing. These will not give us another harvest by tomorrow. If today was the last harvest we got from them today, that would be today. The flowers, I can ship them in tomorrow. I don't have to do it today. The corn I can keep up. The blueberries I'll probably have to destroy on the first day of farm, or the first day of the first day of fall. The tomatoes, I'm gonna see if I can get anything from them, but I don't think I will. Okay, so actually, yeah, we spent a lot of time here. And it's only been an hour since I've started this episode. I guess because I've been going through them so very quickly. Like, I'm sorry. Wow. I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry that I've been making some, making these last few episodes very, very quick, and providing like very bland, in my opinion, bland commentary. Like, I truly am. I'm sorry about that, guys. I really am. I don't mean to do that. I don't. But you know, when you like, this is such a long playthrough. Especially when you get to the point of the playthrough where it's pretty much you're doing the same thing kind of on a daily basis. You know, it gets, there's nothing you don't get to talk about. You don't, it's kind of hard to talk about stuff. Now, if this was like a live stream, it would be a little bit more interactive, because if there's people watching, they can always ask you questions, always talk to you. So you have more things to talk about. I think, other than when you're doing a recording by yourself, and you just kind of have to talk to yourself, more or less. Well, talk to the audience who's not there, and yeah, it's just like, it's kind of hard to do that. Okay, so why don't I have an, star fruit seeds. What am I looking for? I am looking for star fruits. 16. I need 8 more of these seeds. Okay, I'm going to see how I can make some more seeds out of here. I don't feel like. I was like, definitely the gold stars will be going away. Alright, so let me get these. Alright, so I need 8 more seeds. I need 24. And I just noticed that, yeah, that wood thing is gone. Is it this one? Yes, this one. Thunderstorm is nice to have every now and then. My god, man, they destroy everything on your farm. One. Maybe this one will give me 4. No, that gave us 1. It makes me mad because I had to remake some of this stuff. Okay, 24. That's perfect. And some of the stuff I'm okay with remaking. I'm like, okay, whatever. Like the fences and stuff. Even though the fences do get on my nerves whenever they get destroyed, or they get all crumbly and stuff. Like that's, to me, that's, I don't know. Okay, that's fine. Alright, that's just to be expected. No, man, not one of some of the stuff you hear, you know, some of the stuff here you got that just like purely decorative, like right there, it's like, look at this, it's fucking gone, well, it's right there. But if you don't notice it the day it happens, it just disappears completely. I guess the only way you can prevent that is if you build a bunch of lightning rods like everywhere. Alright, so let's put the last of these star fruits in, and I think we're done for today. Yes, we are. Alright, give my wife a good night kiss, and we'll go straight to bed, and we'll continue on. Not next time, we got one more day to go, guys. We got one more day. Oh, wow, well, we broke the 100. We broke the 100K mark now, guys. 113,000. Let's look how much money we got from the star fruits. Just the star fruit itself. 41 gold star. We got 54,000 gold from that. Oof. That's a lot. I think that actually almost, that actually, I think that got me up to 900,000. Oh wow, I was about 100,000 off. Oh jeez. I honestly did not think all the star fruit was gonna be like pop up all like that. Hi baby girl. I remember, so we'll probably be getting you that item very, very soon. And I forgot to decorate the bedroom. Okay, let me just take this. It's okay, guys. Hi honey, I'll see you at the festival tonight. Alright, so today we can take a little bit more time to do stuff because the festival don't start until later tonight. It's around 10 o'clock, so we don't have to do much of anything for today. Okay, so... today, I guess our last day here is going to be pretty much our longest day because we're going to be doing a lot of stuff. But we're going to do a lot of waiting around, more or less. But it'd be a nice way to end off the summer. Our long summer days. Until we come back into our short summer, into our short fall week. And possibly with our short farm week, we can actually finish our last bundle that has been haunting us for the past year. And catch that elusive walleye fish that we need. And actually complete the community center. This is the reason why I haven't ended a playthrough, because of that damn fish. I was like, there's no, I can't end it because like I haven't completed the community center, because completing the community center is not essential to completing the game at all. But to me, I feel like that is one of the more, that was one of my accomplishments. That was one of the things I wanted to finish. That was the main thing I wanted to finish before I decided to end the playthrough. Because to me, that is the one of the biggest things that's one of the things that you concentrate on the hardest was that bundle list. You know, you work hard for it. If you didn't go with the Joja Corporation, that was what you went with. You went with bundles. You know, and to me, that makes the game super fun. You know, it's like, I need to do that. I was like, I want to finish that. I want to complete that. I want to complete all the bundles. That's what... I don't know what the game is about, but to me, that was one of the core essential things that... if you played the game, that was one of the things that you had to do to me. That you had to finish. You had to finish. You know, you can say, oh yeah, I beat Stardew Valley. I played it for 3 years and I did that. I was like, did you do all the bundles? Like, I didn't do the bundles. I went with, you could be like, I went with, the Joja Corporation. I was like, okay. Did you get all the particular upgrades to town? Like, did you... did you get all the upgrades, all fix all the things that was wrong in town, that got rid of the rock, glittering rock, got fixed the town, fixed the bridge to the quarry, did you fix the bus so you can go to the desert, you know, just all these other little small things that you should have done. Good game. Now, to me, like, is it necessary to get married to consider yourself you have beaten the game? No, it's not. Marriage is just something that's very... marriage, like, in all the, like, all these games and, like, all the horror movies in these games, it's very... marriage is just optional. Marriage is not something that you have to actively do and complete. Like, get married before you finish the game. Like, no, you didn't. It was not a necessary thing. It's just one of those, to me, if marriage is optional to me. Optional to the game, to complete the game, because you don't need to be married to do everything you got to do here. For me, I play these types of games. To me, marriage is always a requirement for me. Like any Harvest Moon game, I always have to get married. To me, that just enriches the experience even more than, you know, what you get. So to me, when I play like any Harvest Moon game or any games of this type of genre that allows marriage, like I have to do it. Like I have to do it. To me, that's a requirement. I can't skip that. Like it's not an absolute requirement to beat the game. Like in here and all the other Harvest Moon games, but to me, it is something that you need. To me, it is always a requirement, pretty much. Like here. Basically, it's not even a requirement to do anything here in the game. You don't need a farm, you don't need a community center, you don't need to do a community center, you don't need to do anything. And this game is open-ended, you can do whatever you want, you can do whatever the hell you want to do. Like, no one can tell you you can't do something. Are these trees ever going to grow? Or they're not growing because of... I was like, are they not growing because of the stone stuff around them? If they're not, then... Oopsies. Alright, so that gets rid of those. I need to get rid of these now. Alright, and that should finish off my harvests for the day. Oh, we gotta go to the greenhouse too, actually. No truffles today, my dear piggies? Guess not. And I need to check how much food I have left for the animals themselves. I should have enough for... Okay. I have enough for the next 2 days. Alright. 54... 2 days. I'm gonna need enough to have at least for another 3 days. So let me just get some of these going. Oh, to me, they really make a. I think he really did. He did really make a really great use of grass in this game. Because beforehand, grass wasn't that essential to me. Grass was always something like, oh, you can do it if you want to, or you can just have a big plot, and grass always regrows. So. In a single spot, like all the Harvest Moon games, grass was always a regrowable thing. Once you had like a set area for this, like this is all where I can grow all my grass. Once you cut the grass stays there. The grass stays where it's at, and you just kind of pretty much like okay, the grass is here, whatever. And the grass just regrows over and over and over. And during the summer, during winter, the grass stays where it's at and doesn't move. Alright, so I need to move this table. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna move this table right here. And I need to move this lamp. Actually, I don't like it right there. I'll put it right here. Yeah, right here's good. That could be the chair down here. I know it looks weird, but you know, whatever. It's my house, whatever. Okay, you don't have no say what I can put in my house. It's not your house. Mine. Alright, so we just gotta wait around to 10 o'clock. It's not ready, baby. That's kinda hard. It's kinda weird that she says that now, that we've been married for a whole year. It'd be nice to say, I can't believe we've been married for a whole year. Alright, so the only thing we need to keep growing are our wheat and our corn. Nothing else. Everything else is pretty much... Everything else is, you know what? I will drink this. Let's get crunk. Like, everything else is pretty much on. Yeah, make some wheat juice, man. Boom. Like, everything else is pretty much on. Oh, pretty much done. Oh, everything else is pretty much over with. Can't do anything else with those crops. Wheat and corn are the only two crops that cross over into the fall, which is actually really nice. So I won't make that same mistake again where I got rid of the corn and realized that, didn't realize like, oh, pine, birch, eh, nothing I really want. Guess what I can do today, guys? I can go fishing. I'm just gonna fish because there's nothing else to do. I gotta wait until 10 o'clock. I know you guys haven't seen this in like, when was the, honestly, what, now that I think about it, when was the last time I fished, episode-wise? Well, I think it was kind of hard to catch. Boom, boom. Like, when was the last time I episode fished? I think it was, I'm guessing it was maybe spring. I don't think, no, it wasn't spring. I think it was probably back in winter was the last time I fished. Alright. Like, I wanted to get that before, just before I caught the fish. And I wanted to get the meter high enough. Let's see what we got in this treasure chest. Oh, more fucking, more, lot more bait, actually. Let's put that in there. Gonna catch the fish, gonna catch the fish. There's a lot of pikes in here. A lot of pipes. That was not a pike. I don't know why some people don't like the fishing in this game. I enjoy the fishing. It's not simplistic. I mean, it's simplistic, but it's a mini game though. It's fun to have mini games. Kind of, it breaks up. Like, it breaks up the, I guess the monotony of making things super simple or something like that. Like, all the hardest things, the fishing, the hardest things have always been simple. Fishing. Almost 10, it's almost 10. Catching nothing but, we've been catching nothing but pikes in here. Where's Abigail? What are you doing down here, Abigail? Alright, so I'm just gonna go ahead and head off towards the beach area. But this has been a very, very great summer, actually. We made a lot of money this summer. A lot more than I anticipated. So we end up for probably about $940,000. Summer, I think summer and fall are the two biggest seasons to make money. Spring, you don't get that much. Spring, you don't get too much money. Just because the crops themselves don't sell well. But where do you make more money off, season-wise? I think summer is the best season to get money. Usually it's fall, But because of the star fruits, the star fruits is the probably the biggest game changer in the summer. Because star fruits sells for so much money. Alright, so it's about to hit 10. Alright, so let's go ahead and finish our summer off with our last festival of the summer. The Midnight Jellies. And as we always do, we always go around and talk to everybody. Hello. And everyone just says pretty much the same thing they said last year. This is a really nice event, I think. A little nice festival. Even though it's very simplistic and it's just kind of here and there, it's just kind of like, oh, this is what happens. But to me, this is probably... this is probably one of the better just seasonal things. Just because you really feel the, I guess the special, you really just feel how unique and special this whole place is. You know, and I'm not saying that there's not places like this around the world. There is, like, there is some areas around the world that are almost like, just like this, you know. Where, you know, life is not complicated for them. Life is not that much of a complication to them. You know, they just have easy things they think about and things, easy things they go with. You know, just like really natural, just really like old school things, you know, just really like super countryside. Like homes, like just, there are towns that are just like this. Or areas around the world like this, you know, where they're not worry about the fast hustle and bustle of the city. You haven't talked to me, really? Let's go ahead and launch the boat then. Alright, so apparently, they changed where your spouse is supposed to be standing with you. Okay, now she is. Cause last time I did this, she wasn't standing with me. So, as you see, I'm standing here with my spouse, beside another couple. You know, I don't know if there is any kind of event like this in the world. Just, like, you can see... I know you can see... Sometimes you can see jellyfish underneath the water, especially at night, and I guess some of them do glow, I don't know for sure. But I think if there was ever something, you know, this kind of spectacular that actually existed, that's known, well known of, I would love to see this. I would really love to see this. I think this is, it just looks magical to me. Even just in this pixelated game, and just in this 16-bit game form like this, it looks magical as hell. And there's the green one right there. He always comes up. And this music here is so good, man. This music is fantastic. And I think this song makes this whole festival magical. Towards the great unknown. All right, and that will finish up our day here in the for our last day of summer and our last summer of the playthrough. All right, so let's just go ahead straight to bed. Let's see if Haley has anything special to say to us. Oh, not really. All right, let's just go to bed, honey. All right. And okay, my cursor's gone, like always. Well, let me find my cursor before I give you guys the end tag here. Cursor. Okay, there we go. Let's leave it there. All right. So thank you guys for watching the video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys like some of the comments. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know it hasn't been the most colorful commentaries for the past few episodes. I guess because I've been just really just been pushing these out, and it hasn't been, to me, well, it's not like the game's not fun or anything. It's just, to me, it's just like, it's kind of boring to play. It's kind of boring now to play because everything's automatic and it's not enough, I guess, excitement and not enough goals to have. But hopefully next month will be a little bit more exciting. Hopefully we can get our fish that we need to complete the bundle. We can see the last kind of the last major event of the game, cutscene wise. And then we'll see what happens there. I'm really excited to see. I got a rain totem already, so I want to make damn sure it's gonna rain this time around. We're not gonna deal with what we had last year, last fall, with no fucking rain the whole month. That was stupid. But anyways, thank you guys for watching the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like, comment, share the video, and last but not least, subscribe to the channel, please. Like I said, please there, but yes, please subscribe to the channel, guys. Anyways, thank you guys for watching, and that's it for me. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. See ya.